fabulous people, welcome and welcome back to my channel. My name is Scholastica, and on this channel I talk about how you can travel abroad without spending money on travel agents. So if that is something you are interested in, then stick around. In this video, we're going to be talking about how to raise money to travel abroad, especially when you are broke and you have nobody to rely on financially. Trust me guys, I know it's hard, money is not easy to come by, but I am not in support of anybody selling their properties or anybody getting loans from banks or friends, all in the name of traveling abroad. I am not in support of that. So watch this video to the end and you'll be able to gain something. I hope you'll be able to learn something at the end of this video that will help you to build your account balance from ₦0 to the amount that you are looking for to fund your travels abroad. So I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Hey guys, welcome back. So let me start with a short story. I lost my dad when I was 9 years old and I had to watch my mom raise 4 children on her own without any support from family, relatives, friends. You guys know how hard it is in Nigeria. It's not easy for a woman to raise 4 children on her own, especially when they are still that young and they've just started school. So it was a really trying time. Growing up, I watched my mom take a lot of loans just so she can pay her school fees, and the only thing that was in the back of my head then was like, I want to finish school, I want to get a job so that I can support my family financially. In fact, I think that was one of the major reasons why I decided to become a nurse. I actually didn't want to be a nurse from the beginning. I was good at writing, so I wanted to be a writer. I wanted to be something other than nursing. But my love for nursing actually started after I gained admission to School of Nursing. So anyway, fast forward to like a few years later after I finished my nursing education and I got a job. Guys, it was not even as easy as I was thinking it would be, because my first job was paying me 35,000 naira. Then it looked like a big amount. It looked like, oh, I'm earning 35,000 naira finally. But guys, it was not enough at all. I had a lot of responsibilities. I had people to support, and 35,000 naira was nothing compared to the amount that I was looking at, like the vision of the money that I was seeing in the future. 35,000 naira was nothing compared to that. So I decided to change cities. I left Delta State and I moved to Lagos State. And in Lagos, I was earning 75,000 naira as a nurse, which was better. But remember that the cost of living in Lagos was like way higher than what it was in Delta State. So even though I was earning much, I still could not support my family the way I wanted to. Luckily, my mom was still working, so she was still able to get some pay, like, to support my siblings. But I knew that that was going to end one day because she was going to retire. So anyway, why am I even talking about this story? It's all related. This is taking me to my first tip, which is know your why. Why exactly do you want to travel abroad? It could be that you want to support your family or you want to advance your career. Why do you want to travel abroad? Know your why. And if you can know your why, then that why becomes a motivation. It becomes the driving force for you to be able to attain the other tips that I'm going to talk about in this video. Now, after you've known your why, the other thing for you to put at the back of your mind is, what exactly are you going to do when you travel abroad? Are you going abroad to work? Are you going abroad to school? Are you going abroad to hustle? See, if you have the plans of coming abroad to hustle, just cancel that plan, because hustle here is hard. It's hard, and it's going to be very hard for you to even stay legally in the country if you don't have any backup plan and you are just coming to hustle. Every time I'm in a conversation and someone tells me that, hey Scholar, I want to travel abroad, the first thing I ask is, what are you going abroad to do? Are you going abroad to work? Are you going abroad to school? If it's none of those two things, then it's going to be hard, unless if you want to marry, all in the name of staying abroad. And guys, that is not even advisable. So if your purpose of traveling abroad is to work, then it's even easier on you, because most of the time your employer is going to pay for your visa fee, your flight fare, your first month accommodation. And you know that when you are traveling abroad, you have a salary to depend on monthly, so you will get by. But you also have to put in the back of your mind that before you get the job, you have to be spending money from your pocket. So you still have have to pay for your exams. If you're a nurse, you have to pay for IELTS, you have to pay for CBT, you have to do your TB test, your police clearance. All those things cost money and they are going to be coming from your pocket. Now, if you are a student, you are planning to come abroad to study, you have to think of the program that you can afford. I would say don't pick a program that is so expensive. You can start small because the aim now is to like get your step in, right? Start small. Just look for a cheap program that you can afford and then start building, start planning towards it. And after you get that, then you can now move to your next level. Now, after you've found out why you want to travel abroad and you've already known what you are going to do abroad, the next step for you to do is to start from where you are. Which brings me to my second tip. Start from where you are. To raise money is not easy. I should know. Not everybody comes from a rich background. Not everybody has rich uncles and aunties that are willing to like throw money at you to just go and travel abroad. Not everybody has that kind of lifestyle. So if you are somebody like me that you don't have anybody to actually fall back on, to rely on financially, then start from where you are. Because when I was in Lagos then, I was earning 75,000 a month as a nurse. And from that 75,000, I was able to save 50,000 monthly from my salary. Don't ask me why. It was very hard. I was living in a bedsitter. In Delta State, we call it bedsitter. In Lagos, we call it Sefcon. It's just like a room, kitchen and bathroom, and that is it. And it was small, guys, it was small. But the thing is that I was not even looking at my current situation. I was looking at the next 5-10 years to come, because that's one thing with me. I plan my next 5 years in advance. Those that are close to me, they know about this, so they know that whatever I want to achieve in the next 5 years, I start making plans towards that now, and that is going to affect the decisions I take now. So start from where you are. So even if you're like a secondary school teacher and you are not really earning a lot of money, maybe you're earning 50,000 a month, from that 50,000 you can still save some money from that money monthly, and before you know it, single drops of water makes a mighty ocean. Abi, is that not the saying? Single drops of water makes a mighty ocean. So keep on saving, and before you know it, you'll get to your target. Cut down your spending, and that will bring me to my next tip, which is learn a skill and monetize it. It's very easy to learn a skill back in Nigeria. Trust me, guys. That's one of the biggest regrets I have. I wish I had learned some skills before coming abroad, because now I'll be making a lot of money from home. But since you are still in Nigeria and you're watching this video, you still have time. Learn a skill. Tailoring. Could learn how to make hair. Bead making. There are a lot of skills for you to learn. Learn those skills. Monetize them. Don't just learn the skill and just sit down at home and be like, oh, I learned how to sew, I'm just going to sew for myself and nobody else. I learned how to make hair, I'm just going to make my own hair, I'm not going to make anybody's hair. How are you going to make money if you are stingy with those skills? And like I said, it's very easy to learn skills in Nigeria. Just walk up to any salon and tell them that you want to intern under them. It's very easy. Just buy a crate of drink and give to the madam, and the madam will be so happy to take you under her wings. The same with tailoring. Guys, see, tailoring, there's a lot of money in tailoring, even in Nigeria. Do you know how much I spend just to sew like up and down native? I'm sure you guys watching this video, you would know. You probably spend like at least 20,000 just to sew a complete up and down for a wedding or something. So guys, monetize your skill, because it's not just going to benefit you when you are in Nigeria. Even when you travel abroad, you are still going to be earning money from that skill. So don't think that learning a skill is not worth it if you have plans of traveling abroad. It is 100% worth it. I actually have a video about essential skills to learn before moving abroad. I'm going to leave the link of that video here or here, one of those two. I'm going to leave the link to that video there, so make sure you watch it so you have an idea of the kind of skills that you can learn that will benefit you when you travel abroad. So my next tip is to start a small business with a lot of profit margin. Starting a business in Nigeria is easy. Trust me. When I was in nursing school, and a lot of you that are watching this video, if you are nurses, you would relate. In nursing school, we were not really allowed to make our hair. So it was either your natural hair or low cut. And I know there are a lot of people then in nursing school that want to turn up in the weekend, like they want to go and visit their boyfriend, they want to have fun, they want to party. And then it's really a lot of stress to like make your hair Friday night and then start removing it Sunday night just so you can go to school Monday morning. So I came up with an idea. I went online. I actually went to is it AliExpress? Yeah, AliExpress.com, and I bought weft clips. I bought 100 weft clips, and then I bought some weavons in Nigeria. So all I did was that I sewed the clips to the weavon, and it became snap clips, clipping hair extensions, right? So what I did was that I bought these weft clips from AliExpress, and then I bought weavon in Nigeria, then made the two together, like just sewing the weft clip to the weavon, and that gave me clip in hair extensions. And guys, I made money from that. See, I was buying like 100 weft clips for like less than $5 at the time. I don't know how much it is right now, but at the time it was less than $5. So I'll buy like 100 weft clips, and for each head, for each full head, I'll use like 20 weft clips for the complete attachment or for the complete weave-on. So what you do is that you just sew it on, clip it in, and then brush your hair on top, and it looks as if you made your hair. And then you go out, when you come back, so just take off the clips and you're good to go. And guys, that is so there. I was making money then. Only today I start this hustle. So I was selling 20 clips, because 20 clips was enough for one full head. I was selling 20 clips for 5,000 naira. From that 20 clips alone, I already got my capital and I already got my gain from that 20 clips. And remember, I still had like another 80 that is yet to be sold. So just imagine selling, or let's say just imagine buying 100 clips for like 5,000, both the shipping and everything, 5,000, and then selling 20 of those clips for like 5,000 each. And I'm going to charge you extra if you want me to sew the clips for you, which is very easy. It's just to get needle and thread, get your weave on and sew the clips. But there are some people that will be like, oh, I don't want to spoil it, just do it for me. I'm going to charge you for that, baby, because that's not free. So that's what I meant by start a small business with a lot of profit margin. I actually think I was the first person that started that business in Konga. Guys, I was making a lot of money. Even those that were not in nursing school, even those that were just like normal business people, they would send me orders. I would just do it and ship to them, and it was really, really easy. I stopped that business because I was finding it hard to find time to be shipping out orders while I was still at work, because guys, it was not easy to be getting permission every time that I want to go out, I want to go out to do this, I want to go out to do that. So that was how my business failed. But for some of you that don't have that restriction, you can think of a small business that you can do. There are a lot of things. Think of any need that you can meet, and then meet that need, and you are going to be rich. And if you are a student and you are thinking, oh, I don't have money to do this, I don't have money to start a business, what about coaching students? You can start coaching students, you can start doing home tutoring, you can start selling handouts. There are some students that are really, really lazy to read, and you can just compile like bullet points or compile a short summary of the whole lecture for that day and sell it. And guys, you're going to make a lot of money from doing that, because like I said before, students are lazy, they don't want to carry the whole textbook and read. So if they can get it in a simplified manner, you're going to have a lot of customers. So that's a business tip for you. Another business tip for you as a student is that, you know how people rush to school and they don't have breakfast, they don't eat anything, and there are times that they stay in school for a long time. You can start packaging small shops, right? You can start doing small shops, package them well, and then take them to school and sell. You're going to make money from that. See, there are a lot of business that you can do with very little capital. You can start a lot of businesses and you can get a lot of profit from those businesses, and you can start saving up towards your goal. You have to be very strict with your spending. Don't be somebody that by the time you make 5,000 naira as profit, then you want to buy something of 1,000 naira to congratulate yourself for making that profit. Don't do that. So another tip, if you're a student, or if not just for student alone, but if you are planning to come abroad to study, you can start thinking of scholarship programs. There are a lot lot of schools, there are a lot of countries that you can go to study for free or that has very low tuition fee. Let me not say for free now, but some that will have very low tuition fee, some that will have like fully funded scholarships or 50% scholarships. Aim for those kind of courses, aim for those kind of countries. Everybody must not come to the UK. The UK is becoming very strict now. Look for other European countries. European countries are actually very good when it comes to study. Most of them will give you scholarships to actually study in their country. So look towards those countries and then get a program, travel abroad. When you are there, you can start making money. Remember, guys, don't settle. Like I said before, you can use this as a stepping stone. Even if, let's say, okay, my aim is to travel to US, live in US, but I don't have the money to go to US right now. What can I do? I can travel to Germany. Germany is cheap. Germany, I can study in Germany, and in Germany, I can get a fully funded program. And I use Germany as a stepping stone. While I'm in Germany, I can work 20 hours a week. I don't know if that applies to Germany as well, but I think so. You can start making money even as a student in Germany and then save money, because then the money you are going to be saving will have higher value than the Naira. So you can save more money from there. If you have a skill, the better for you. You know how to cut hair, you know how to fix nails, you know, stuff like that. You can start saving money. So you can keep on climbing higher and higher until you get to the stage where you want to be. As humans, I don't think there is a stage where we'll be and be like, yes, I'm comfortable staying in that stage. I feel like we want to keep attaining higher heights. So don't settle for less. Just keep going higher and don't give up. Like my mom will always say, if you don't know where you are going in life, anywhere they show to you will look like it. That brings me back to the first the first tip, which is know your why and know how you are going to get there. If you are enjoying this video and you've gotten any value from this video at all, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up. See, the more you give me a thumbs up, the more you share this video, it lets the algorithm know that, oh yes, I enjoyed this video and I think other people will benefit from this video. That is why it's very important to like the video, share the video. And guys, if you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please help your girl, help the hustle. Support my channel, guys. Subscribe to my channel and I'll see you guys in my next video. I love you guys. Until next time. Bye.